Before we continue with the rest of the video, we could use your help. Click that like button to help spread the word about Watch JoJo, and also be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. This soldier was alone and surrounded, but the brutal way he took on 40 enemy troops is insane. Is it possible to kill 40 enemies all alone and be the shield for your colleagues? Herbert K. Palau is the answer to this question. During the Korean War, he had achieved this feat. So, who is Private First Class Herman K. Palau? He was born in October 1928 in Honolulu. Palau was the youngest of his 9 brothers and 5 sisters. He had a knack for music and was an accomplished singer. His knack for music came from the fact that he was well known as a good ukulele player. After completing his graduation in 1948, Palau was busy with his further studies in administration and accounting. But around that time in 1950, the Korean War broke out and Palau was called for his services. His duty towards his country helped him overcome his strong Christian beliefs and other notions. He started his basic training at the Fort Shafter Military Base in Honolulu, where he was given a Browning automatic rifle. The weapon that Palau acquired had the capacity to fire 650 rounds per minute. In 1951, Palau had his first encounter with war against North Korea. It was known as the Battle of the Bloody Bridge, where the Korean People's Army was fighting UN troops consisting of the US Army. Though the peace talks were going on, there was no lack of harsh combat. A 10-day-long battle was fought to win over the hill all over again. At that point in time, the North Koreans had to retreat because they were outflanked and cut off by the opposition. Although North Korea retreated, they didn't go too far back and made their base at the place that became famous by the name Heartbreak Ridge. The tactics employed by General Thomas DeShazo were questionable because by the time they reached the summit, they were completely exhausted and could not put up a fight against the North Korean troops who were bustling with energy. Therefore, the obvious happened and the Americans and the French had to retreat. At the summit, there were instances where the hand-to-hand combat along with trench knives and grenades took place very frequently. Hill 931 of Heartbreak Ridge was one significant fight where Palau single-handedly helped his colleagues to retreat and run for safer pastures. Till evening, the Americans were able to reply to the Korean attack with the help of artilleries. At around 10 p.m., the North Korean troops wreaked havoc on the Palau's troop, along with another one when the platoon was directly facing the North Korean artillery with limited ammunition. It was time to take quick call, and the platoon decided to retreat and come back with reinforcements. Palau was the last man in the rear guard, and he ensured that his platoon was safe. He fought 40 North Koreans alone with trench knives. Prior to that, he used the limited ammunition to his benefit and also threw hand grenades. This is how Palau helped his platoon, but could not save his own life. Inspiring, isn't it? Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell to stay up to date with our daily videos.